Tom Jew, are you sure you don't want to be in my video? Okay.
Hi everyone, it's Monica. Thanks for tuning in. Alright, so before we get started, I just had to say thanks. You guys have been giving me some really great and positive feedback, and I just totally did not expect that at all. Honestly, I've been checking my emails quite frequently because I've been receiving a lot of YouTube notifications from you guys, and seriously, you just know how to make a girl smile, so thanks. So here's another video of another 10 useful and free Android apps for you guys. So, let's get cereal. Dang it. Alright, number one is DIY Locker. This is basically an app where you can tweak your lock screen without overdoing it. It's a lock screen personalizer. That's not a word until now. You can actually choose your icons and what to place as them, as well as its colors and the shapes. You can also apply a password and multiple widgets simultaneously, so everything is pretty much there and customizable. Kind of streaming along the same idea is Locker Master. This is another lock screen personalizer, but it contains a lot more variables that you can set. You can create your theme and upload it to share with others, or you can just go ahead and download another person's creation for your use. It's pretty simple to use. All you have to do is start off with a background image, and you literally just choose whatever you want to edit afterwards. So you can customize your clock, some text, the unlock, and other various decorations. So have fun with it and share. Moving on to our third app is the Smart App Lock. This app just allows you to set a password on your selected apps so that it prevents others from viewing it unless they have the password to it too. And it will actually take multiple photos of the perpetrator if they try to hack into your lock, which I think is pretty extreme. But it could happen. It's particularly useful for apps that have sensitive information or notes that you'd like to protect. But we all know what it's obviously going to be useful for, if you know what I mean. You know, personal bank accounts. Am I right? I knew that's what you were thinking too. Obviously. Numero cuatro is ClaireSketch. This is an app that allows you to live record on a blank canvas of you sketching or on a photo that you already have in your album. Now, even though I already have a note, I find this app particularly useful because I can simply just pull up a photo really quick and draw on it for fun or for some instructional use. When you're done, you can choose to save it or export it for further use, so just sketch away. Magic. Ooh. Number five is, where's my droid? Where's my droid, dude? Where's my droid, dude? I have problems. This is an extremely useful app when you have lost your phone or unfortunately gotten it stolen by some douchebag. It allows you to GPS track your phone's exact location just by sending some text with your own customizable words. Now, the GPS is actually quite accurate, which I find a little disturbing, just because it provides a longitude, a latitude, the speed at which your phone is traveling, and even providing an address in a Google Maps. So even if your phone is on silent, if you activate it with the ring, it will actually still make an obnoxious sound. Just like so. Oh my god, the flash is going off. I didn't know it does that. Until you have your phone and click the found phone button, it will keep doing this until it dies. Shh, chill out. Moving on to number six is I don't know how to pronounce it, but it was formerly known as Line, and this is my go-to photo editing app. It offers a lot of options such as adjustable filters, frames, texts, stamps, stickers, and etc. And it's pretty easy to maneuver around, and overall it's a pretty good editing app for your photos. In my last app video, I actually presented and used an app called Screen Recorder, which I use to put my videos here, but I actually found another one called AZ Screen Recorder. Right now, I'm actually using the AZ Screen Recorder, as you can see right here. It just has a few more options, such as adjusting the bitrate, minimizable toolbar, and a button where you can see where I'm actually clicking on the screen. There are a few extras that do cost you money, such as using a front-face camera and etc. But if you're just looking for an app just to simply record your screen, well, here it is. Alright, number 8 is the Shazam app. This is a useful app for when you are out somewhere and you hear a lovely song that you would like to download, but the problem is that you don't know the artist or the song title. But Shazam is here to help you out! Yeah! So all you have to do is open up the app and simply click the Shazam button. It will try to automatically detect the song you're looking for, but of course your song should be playing at a reasonable volume so that it can distinguish any background noise along with it. I've personally tried this and it's been working really well for me, even on foreign songs such as Korean songs, and even on songs that are pretty outdated from a long time ago, or songs that are playing on the radio today. So, alright, next on the list is an app called Zedge. This app basically provides a lot of wallpapers and ringtones and notification tones that you can just download and use on your phone. This is where I get pretty much all my wallpapers for my backgrounds, and it's pretty good because people are constantly uploading it, so it is being updated and you get new content quite frequently. So yeah, you can get some pretty cool notification tones like this, or this. Or this. This is one of my favorite games, if you know where this is from. Alright, we're finally on our last app, number 10. This app is not useful at all. I just wanted to throw in another fun app that you might want to download. And to be quite honest, I kind of ran out of useful apps. So here it is, number 10. It's called Androidify. This is an app that basically lets you create an Android version of yourself. I just think it's kind of fun and you can pick a lot of options to make it do some crazy stuff. So go Androidify yourself! Yeah! Alright, well that is the end of my 10 useful, well 9 useful and free Android apps. I hope that you really enjoyed them and they were of some help to you. Let me know how it works out for you, and if it's your first time watching this video, make sure to check out my last video of my other 10 favorite and useful apps, as I magically make it appear right here! Ooh, magic! I'm a wizard! Thanks for watching, you guys! I hope you like these apps, and I hope you have an awesome day! Yeah! All right, number uno, number uno. Afterwards, you just pick whatever you want to customize. Freaking birds! Why is nature so rude?
Número cuatro.
So dramatic.
Ow.
I forgot what I was gonna say.
Words. Come out, please!
Allows you to GPS track your exact location. Well, your phone's exact. Not your exact location. Are you a robot with the chip?
Robot with the chip!
New editing app for Instagram photos or just...
Freaking rude phone! Interrupting me when I'm talking!
Go to photo editing app. My phone is seriously demented right now. It's gonna kill me. Hello?
Let me do a search for an answer to my phone. Is Susie, what is the key beeping at me?
Ironically, I'm eating broccoli right now.
I'm sorry. I'm a sick person.
No, don't eat me, please.
But you're my favorite vegetable. I can't help it.